because of what the Lord has done for us. We give Him thanks.
Feeling is given to us here. About 99% of us will not be here. Yeah. I'm in serious pain, so please permit me to sit.
Amen.
The one thing that we know is that when we go into a court of law, when the magistrate comes, they arrive at a decision, the magistrate does not need to stand up, exert so much force, and shout and say, have been condemned, you are going to jail. The magistrate has the power, he has the authority. So even when they say that Mr. X, you will be sent to jail for 5 years, they hit the gavel, whether their voice is up or down, it does not matter.
Amen.
It is the law that we have come to decree, and it doesn't matter whether sorry about that. So it doesn't matter whether we shout. Can you guys hear me?
Yes. Yes.
It doesn't matter whether we shout, whether we use so much force, but the Lord is in His holy temple.
Amen.
And we have come to make those declarations. Amen.
Amen. Yes.
Now, the one thing that I want us to know is that the government of the Lord rests upon the shoulders of the two or three who are gathered together in His name.
Amen.
It doesn't matter if, you know, the season was different and with 1,000 people here, the two or three who are gathered in His name have the government of the Lord upon their shoulders. So we have come to decree, and we are drawing from Isaiah 9, 6, and 7, which tells us, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end.
Amen.
Upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to order it and establish it with judgment and justice from that time forward, then forever.
Amen.
The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Amen.
That's right.
Christ, who had this authority, told us that when two or three are gathered together in His name,
Amen.
He's in the midst of them. It is that same Christ who told us that we should go. We should go. After He told us He has received all authority in heaven and on earth.
Amen.
So we have come with that same unction. And the government is upon our shoulders. And the declarations we'll make will be established. They will become the law of the land. Amen.
Amen.
In Isaiah 56, we find something interesting. The authority has been given to us to not permit people to speak certain things. The authority of God has been given to us to stop people from saying certain things. And I just read from verse 3. It says, do not let the son of foreigner who has joined himself to the Lord speak, saying, the Lord has utterly separated me from his people. Now let the inner say, here I am, a dry tree. For thus says the Lord, to the eunuchs who keep my Sabbath, and choose what pleases me, and hold fast my covenant. Even to them I'll give my house, and within my walls a place and a name better than that of the sons and daughters. I will give them an everlasting name that shall not be cut off.
Amen.
Also the sons of the foreigner who join themselves to the Lord to serve him and to love the name of the Lord, to be his servant, everyone who keeps from defiling the Sabbath and holds fast my covenant, even them I will bring to my holy mountain and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and their sacrifices will be accepted on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all the nations.
Amen.
The Lord God who gathered the outcasts of Israel says, yet I will gather to him others besides those who are gathered to him. Amen.
Amen.
What we see here is that the Lord is giving us the authority to protect someone's speech when the speech does not reflect the will of God. Every nation has a reserved seating in the house of God.
Amen.
Every nation has priority seating in the house of God.
Yes.
God does not have grandchildren.
That's right.
So you cannot say, oh, the front row is for the sons and the second row for the grandsons. No, 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 no. Each and every one of us has priority seating in the presence of God. Amen.
Amen.
Now, there are some of us who over time, or maybe there's someone you know, who has been sent to the back of the line every time that they make it to the front. Perhaps you know someone like that. Perhaps you know a parent or grandparent or great-grandparent who will pass up from graduating with their peers because of the fact that the system never lets them. And because of that, they were not able to rebound. Perhaps there's someone you know who was incarcerated unjustly, and because he was gone, his wife and children were exposed to drugs, sexual abuse, and they were out of school and all of that. What we are doing here today is that we have come to intervene.
Amen.
We have come to intervene. If you have watched the program, I don't know if it's still there because I don't do TV as much like I used to do. There's a program called Intervention. If things are not working well for you, your family steps in and tells you, because we care this much for you, we are putting an end to this. We are going to hold you back. So we have come here today to say to those who used to say things which are derogatory to them, that we have come to intervene. We will not let you say those things anymore, because that is not your story anymore. Amen. We have come, like we see in that Isaiah 56 verse 7, to usher a joyful house of prayer. Joyful, you know. This government that is upon our shoulders is what we are using to decree this. And we are saying, not on my watch, just like your family and friends will do intervention and say, not on my watch. We are not going to let this happen to you. You've been left in the back burner too long, not anymore, not on my watch. You have been given the short end of the stick for too long, not anymore, not on my watch.
Amen.
That is why we are here. In that Isaiah 56 verse 3, we see the old system where the Jewish people were God's children and there was no room for Gentiles per se. But in this verse, we see the Lord inserting a new compass, because then only the called, the chosen children had certain privileges. But God is inserting a new compass, and it is in our dispensation to call forth that new compass and say, this is ours. He's saying to the prophet that a new season is coming, and in this new season, I don't want the children to speak the language of the old season. The last 400 years have not been nice to us. And because of that, we had a language that was relevant for that season. But today we are saying we are not speaking that language anymore.
Amen.
Amen. Now, we remember the adage, I think this was started way back in 1844, where they said, sticks and stones may break my bones,
lies
will never hurt.
But words will never break me.
Amen.
Tell me about that in the dispensation of social media.
Right.
There are no sticks and bones on social media. But words and words and words are breaking and hurting and destroying.
Amen.
So that was the word for 1844. So we are not going to use that word of 1844 and say it is the word for us today. Amen.
Amen.
We are not going to let them say it. If they do, we will rebuke, we will reprove, we'll go as far as censuring them. Say, don't say it, not on my watch. I'm not going to let that happen. The foreigner does not have the right anymore to say, oh, I do not have the momentum of the slave owners, because their children, they had piled up wealth for their children and their children's children, and they are standing on a new platform which is based on the wealth of the generations. When we hit reparation, there is a new order.
Amen.
And in that new order, there is the unction to accelerate. And in that acceleration, there is the grace that you receive, so that when you start running from the place of the old world, because that old world, which we know is a tenth of the GDP of this country, they are supposed to tithe to the Lord from 1619 to 2019. A tenth of the GDP of this nation shall come to the people who have been held back. Amen.
Amen.
We are decreeing.
Amen. Amen.
So you who is standing on this new unction of the Lord, you will surpass those who were born into, call it, they say it's luck, or, you know, into the right family, into the right color of skin and all of that stuff. You're going to surpass them. Why? Because today we are going to step on the supernatural
Amen.
Contact point, which
Amen.
Is called the altar of reparation.
Amen.
It's going to project us in a supernatural manner. Amen.
Amen.
So this is why the Lord says in his word, let the eunuch not say that I am a dry stick. Let the eunuch not say I'm a dry stick. Because we and our people were not prisoners, we were captives.
Yes.
And
right.
captives are in bondage not because of what they have done. Amen.
Amen.
So we want to remember that the Lord has called us and has told us to seek him first.
Yes.
Seek him first. Seek him first. When
Amen.
We seek him, then all these things will be added unto us. And we know that we are not here by chance. It's because we have been seeking him. Amen.
Amen.
Now, for the diaspora, African diaspora, majority of whom are African Americans, I will read for us Jeremiah 24 verses 1 to 9. The Lord showed me there were two baskets of figs set before the temple of the Lord. That's Jeremiah 24 verse 1 to 9. After Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, had carried away captive Jeconiah, the son of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, and the princes of Judah, with the craftsmen and smiths from Jerusalem, and had brought them to Babylon. One basket had very good figs, like the figs that are first ripe, and the other basket had very bad figs, which could not be eaten. They were so bad. Then the Lord said to me, what do you see, Jeremiah? And I said, figs, good figs, very good. Bad, very bad, which cannot be eaten. They're so bad. Again, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, like these good figs, so will I acknowledge those who are carried away captive from Judah. Like these good feasts, so will I acknowledge those who are carried away captives from Judah, whom I have sent out of this place for their own good into the land of the Chaldeans. For I will set my eyes on them for good, and I will bring them back to this land. I will build them and not pull them down, and I will plant them and not pluck them. Then I will give them a heart to know me, that I am the Lord, and they shall be my people. And I will be their God, for they shall return to me with their whole heart. And as the bad figs which cannot be eaten, they are so bad, surely thus says the Lord, shall I give up Zedekiah, the king of Judah, his princes, the residue of Jerusalem, who remain in this land, and those who dwell in the land of Egypt. I'll deliver them to trouble into all the kingdoms of the earth, for their hand to be a reproach and a byword, a taunt and a curse in all places where I shall drive them. Amen. Amen. Now, when I look at Jeremiah 24, I see what is happening with Africans and all of African descent in the diaspora. We understand that when those who went out to look for slaves, if you were not healthy, if you did not look strong, if you did not look handsome, if you were not capable, you know, they would not take you. And of those whom they took, maybe based on their looks, if they were not resistant and resilient enough, they did not make it in those ships. So the best of the continent was taken out of the continent. And this best of the continent, the Lord says that I sent them out. My eyes are upon them. And the time now has come when the eyes of the Lord that was upon them shall be made manifest. What we know, when you take your time to look at the books of Moses, the one thing that I'm encouraging each and every one of us to do a good job at is ask yourself, why did Moses write these books? Those books were written for us to know that indeed we are God's people. Amen. That Africa is God's people.
Amen.
Isaiah 19:19 tells us we are God's people. Africa is God's people. Descendants of Africa, we are here for a purpose. So, just to encourage us that we know that now is that time. If you look at verses 8 through 9, you know, it tells us what is happening with the continent. Those who were left back, they are still under bondage. There is no government in Africa that is independent. There's no president who is elected as president without the approval of the West. And by approval of the West, it means that you have told them that we can work with you to make sure that you have access to the natural resources of the continent. So, until the cream of Africa rises, the continent will be in perpetual bondage. Mm. And that cream of Africa are those who were taken, who came out, who stood in the foreign land, who fought and obtained their civil rights and liberties, who are today the majority are African Americans. Amen.
Amen.
I will go back and just repeat that Obadiah 1:17. He said, but on Mount Zion there shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness. The house of Jacob shall possess their possessions. Amen. So today, this house of Jacob, these children of African diaspora, especially as we're in this land, the African Americans, we shall receive their possessions. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Now, my words do not matter. The words of the Lord matter.
Amen.
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 So because of that, and in view of HR 40, which we know is out there, I'm going to read a parallel for us from Ezra chapter 6, verses 1 to 12, so that we see that what happened in the days of Ezra is what they're trying to put together in HR 40. And because it happened then, and we know that the word of God is alive and active.
Yes.
And we know that every single word that we see here in scripture is a testimony about Christ. And like the word of God tells us in Psalms 119 and verse 111, you know, the testimonies of Christ have become our heritage. So the word of God is an invitation for us to cause his kingdom to come here on earth. So let me read verse Ezra 6, 1 to 12 for us. And I want you to just bear in mind what happens with HR 40. Say, then King Darius issued a decree, and a search was made in the archives where the treasures were stored in Babylon, and at Akmetha in the palace, that is the province of Media, a scroll was found, and in it a record written thus. That scroll that was found is similar to HR 40. Why do we say that? This request has been out there for years and years and years. The talk of 40 acres and a mule has been out there for hundreds and hundreds of years since 1865.
Yeah.
So what we are doing here today is to, we are calling and we are demanding,
yes,
on the President of the United States. Because in his campaign, he made a campaign promise. He said, if a bill on reparations is brought to my desk, I will sign it into law. So we are now saying that as King Darius issued a decree and a search was made in the archives, that search should go back to the agreement, the proposal made by the African American pastors in 1865, saying that what we need is land. What we need is land. And let those 40 acres of 1865 be interpolated into today's dollars.
Yes.
And, you know, translated into every single family. So that the families of the descendants will benefit from it. It's no mistake why we are here. It's no mistake why Sister Carla is from Yorktown, and she talked about the alliance between the French and the Americans way back when to defeat the United Kingdom. It's no mistake why in 1865, when 40 acres and a mule was proposed, in that same year, the Statue of Liberty was proposed. And it's no mistake why in 2021, when an altar of restoration was raised in Columbia, South Carolina, and on May 11th, 2021 through June 19th, 2021, we went into a 14-day fast. And on June 19th, 2021, which became for the first time, Juneteenth became a federal holiday.
Amen.
On that same day, the French proposed a second Statue of Liberty. And that Statue of Liberty is now in Washington, D.C. Now, when you look at the significance of that Statue of Liberty, we want to refer you to Revelation 17, verse 18. You go and see why that Statue of Liberty should be in the capital city. So when these things are happening, we know it is not by chance. There is a desire to control the wealth of the people of God. Amen. Now, verse 3 of Ezra 6. In the first year of King Cyrus issued a decree concerning the house of God in Jerusalem. Say, let the house be rebuilt, the place where they offered sacrifices, and let the foundations of it be firmly laid, its height 60 cubits and its width 60 cubits, with 3 rolls of heavy stones and 1 roll of new timber. Let the expenses be paid from the king's treasury. And pause there for a second. The expenses were to be paid from the king's treasury. At this time, like a politician, the king concerned was not of the entire kingdom over which Cyprus was king. It was from the area where the temple was to be rebuilt. So in the same way, there is no state in the United States of America that has not benefited from slave labor.
Amen.
So we are asking that every state of this nation will get from their treasury and pay for reparations in this land. Amen. Because it is every state's concern, it becomes a federal issue. So that's what we are decreeing here today, and it will happen. Amen. It says, also, let the gold and silver articles of the house of God, which Nebuchadnezzar took from the temple, which is in Jerusalem, be brought back to Babylon, be restored, be taken back to the temple, which is in Jerusalem, each to its place, and deposit them in the house of God. Amen. Now, therefore, Tetaniah, governor of the region beyond the river, and Shalmaneser, and your companions, the Persians, who are beyond the river, keep yourselves far from them. Let the work of this house of God alone. Let the governor of the Jews and the elders of the Jews build this house of God on its site. The instruction is to leave the people alone. Nobody who has not been a victim of this slavery should interfere in the implementation of this reparation. Once it comes, the governors of the diaspora Africa will be responsible for it, and they will know how to use it. Amen. We are not asking for people to do something and then go ahead and monitor and control and say this is how this is going to be done. It has to be done by African Americans for African Americans. It has to be done for diaspora Americans by diaspora Americans. I mean Africans rather. Amen. It says, moreover, I issue a decree as to what you shall do for the elders of these Jews for the building of this house of God. Let the cost be paid at the king's expense from taxes on the region beyond the river. This is to be given immediately to these men so that they are not hindered. Amen.
Amen.
This is to be given immediately. So I'm going to end right here and we'll continue with other stuff. But what I want us to know is that this response has to come immediately.
Amen.
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 God bless you all.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Three dolphins swimming around the house. So as soon as you were speaking, so it's not on the program, but we did want to put that in because signs must come from the creation.
Yes.
So we just want to wow. God of signs and wonders, you are God of signs.